been drinking all day and was looking for love. I got a call from a girl in the apartment above. She told me to come up and I was happy as hell. I couldn't walk so well, so I stumbled and fell. A 10-story fall down a fire escape. I didn't want to die yet, but it was too late. Halfway down, I saw a flashing light. A dude with a beard came into my sight. He said, my name is God and I've been watching you sin. I'm up here in heaven. Do you want to get in? Apologize before you land. If you don't, then you'll be damned. I'll send you to hell in a handbasket, where you'll burn just like your body will. You're too flat for the damn casket. So I apologize. And when I hit the ground, I felt no pain whatsoever. I just ended up in this clear glass elevator and shot straight upward. Past the clouds. Past more clouds. It took a long time, but eventually I saw the pearly gates of heaven. And when I got to the pearly gates, I noticed that they were very fancy. There's red velvet ropes everywhere. It was very, how do you say, prestigious. And sure enough, I was on the VIP list. So I decided to walk on in. On the first day in heaven, it was kinda cool. I learned to play harp and sat by the pool. Second day, I felt safe and sound, just eating grapes and floating around. And there were clouds everywhere and they were kinda soft, but the novelty of sitting on them soon wore off. I had a couch on earth and it was soft to touch. Sat on that motherfucker way too much. Now by the third day in heaven, I was ready to drink. My tolerance level was starting to shrink. So for the next 4 days, I searched near and far. Not one liquor store, not a single bar. So when the first week in heaven was over, I hadn't had sex and I was totally sober. And that's when it occurred to me, I can't do this for eternity. So I went to God's office and I knocked on his door. I told him I don't want to be up here in heaven anymore. I told him I appreciate you having me as a guest, but I just got one little request. I said, send me to hell in a handbasket. Cause if this right here is heaven, hell sounds fantastic. So God went in the back and did some paperwork. Sure enough, my request was approved. My request to go straight to hell. So after that, I got in the same clear glass elevator and went down. Started going down past the clouds, past the clouds, past more clouds, past the ground, going down, 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 down. It seemed like it took forever, man. It was way down there, but eventually, I got to the gates of hell. The gates of hell, they weren't all Hollywood like the pearly gates. It was just like a red door on a brick wall. It looked like somewhere I would hang out on earth, like a dive bar somewhere, you know? So I went in. On the first day in hell, I didn't like it a lot. It was really, 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 really fucking hot. Hey. The second day I was less concerned, and by the third day I was used to the burn. And on the fourth day I started walking around, realized it was a hell of a town. I saw liquor stores, strip clubs, bar saloons, and all my favorite musicians playing tunes. I saw Eazy-E, ODB, Mozart smoking PCP. I got a shot of whiskey and they said it was free. A little cocktail waitress came up to me. She said, do you want some morphine? I'm headed to an orgy. I want you to escort me. I said, sure please, it's New Orleans on crack. Heaven, I ain't never coming back. I'm a sinner with the liver of a Jack Kerouac. So the devil drive by in a black Cadillac, Biggie sitting next to him in a red and black lumberjack hat. Goddamn, feeling so grand, got another shot of whiskey and I lifted up my hand. I said, hey, it's the new guy. I wanna pose a toast to the devil, not the Father, Son, or Holy Ghost. I'm about to spend infinity years comatose, push it to the limit, it's impossible to overdose. I don't see the need to be forgiven. I'm at peace being a heathen and hedonism. I don't need the key to living, I'm already dead. So I drank and said, I love it here in hell. And what the fuck is a hand basket? Like a picnic basket? It's a weird vehicle to use to go to hell in, wouldn't you say? Do we all have our own hand basket, or is there like a ski lift going back and forth from hell to earth of hand baskets taking people down there? I have no fucking idea. It's a really strange concept, and I just can't grasp it.